It's a bit of joy for my wife and I to be back here for quite a while. And when I was asked to be the substitute in place of my son, who will be the preacher today, Martin John, I was very happy to accept the invitation, the request, knowing that there will be always a blessing, not only for us who will be visiting you here, but you also who will be the recipient of God's word for the message. So my prayer is that at this time I will be a very happy substitute. Gamitin pa rin ang Panginoon ang ating pagsama-sama at sa ating pag-aral ng salita ng Diyos. Okay. So, it's really a joy. We really mean it from the depths of our hearts. And it's good to see once again faces which I saw before. And I think you're getting more familiar to me now. And our prayers is that it will, in God's own time, I hope it will be soon, that we'll be able to call you by your first names. Because that will be really good. That's always our goal, to know people and call them by their first names. And to also spell your names correctly. Okay, so our message today is found in the Gospel of Luke, Luke chapter 16. Starting from verse 19 to verse 31. This is a real fascinating story. And I would like to read this and kindly follow me along quietly while I'm reading the passage, starting from verse 19 up to the last, that's verse 31. There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate, full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the dogs, from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And in hell, he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus, that I may dip the tip of his finger in water, and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receivest thy good things, and likewise Lazarus' evil things. But now he is comforted, and you are tormented. Verse 26, and beside all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from thence. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house. For I have five brothers, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. Abraham said unto him, They have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, Nay, Father Abraham, if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent. 31, and he said unto him, If they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, the one rose from the dead. this is a chilling story. Many Bible teachers, not quite many, a good number of Bible teachers, call this the parable of Lazarus and the rich man. This is not a parable. This is a real story. If you study the parables that Jesus has been telling all throughout his ministry on earth, the parables, all of them, he never mentioned names of characters. That's the big difference. In parables, no names. But how come he mentions the name of the poor man here, the beggar, Lazarus? You might ask the question, how come Jesus didn't mention the rich man's name, right? In those days, the rich man was well known. Who doesn't know President Donald Trump? The expression says, it goes without saying the name. Many already, or almost all, knew whom he was talking about, because it crashed already the headlines. If there were radio and if there were social media at those times, it's all right there. The people already knew who he was talking about. So it's common knowledge, we call it. Okay? So we'll start with this note. I want to really make it clear that this is not a parable. This is not just a story or a legend or a myth like Bathala in the Philippines. Like Huwantamat, you know, the story, you know. It's a real historic story that really happened those times. But here we see three important things in this part. I hope you will read this passage again, maybe sometime tonight, and don't let next week pass by without reading this again, okay? You promise?
Yeah.
Three important things. We notice out of this parable, number one here, from verse 19 up to verse 20, BA, the first part of verse 20, it talks about two lives. So I can make a subtitle here. It's not only the story of the rich man and Lazarus, but the subtitle could be fitly put here, or aptly put here, the story of two men. Two lives. And then verse 20, B, it talks about two deaths. Two deaths. And then from verse 20b up to the last verse, verse 31, two destinies. Two destinies. And it's all in sharp contrast. Two lives, rich and poor. Two deaths, okay, you will see it. I will not mention it so that you will not sleep. Okay, keep on following. Okay, you listen well attentively. And two destinies. Two eternal destinies. We see first here in this story that Jesus said there were two men. One was poor, the other was the poor man here is mentioned by name. Okay. What was the kind of life he lived? I believe he didn't live long, relatively human life on earth. Because if you are always malnourished and you always eat the unbalanced diet, and you are living a life of abject poverty. And you know what poverty matter of fact, we have experienced, most of us, I believe, what it means to be poor. I know what it means to be poor. I grew up in a family of 11. My father was a preacher, but he was a preacher in a country church, small. And the early 1940s, I was born 1943. My father was living a life without fixed salary as a preacher. He was starting out a church before the pioneering, starting the church.